Understood Betsy by Dorothy Canfield. First published in 1917. This unabridged recording was produced in 2005 by Alcazar Audio Works, which holds the copyright thereto. Chapter 1. Aunt Harriet Has a Cough.
When this story begins, Elizabeth Ann, who is the heroine of it, was a little girl of 9 who lived with her great-aunt Harriet in a medium-sized city, in a medium-sized state, and in the middle of this country. And that's all you need to know about the place, for it's not the important thing in the story, and anyhow, you know all about it because it was probably very much like the place you live in yourself. Elizabeth Ann's great-aunt Harriet was a widow who was not very rich or very poor, and she had one daughter, Frances, who gave piano lessons to little girls. They kept a girl whose name was Grace, and who had asthma dreadfully, and wasn't very much of a girl at all, being nearer 50 than 40. Aunt Harriet, who was very tender-hearted, kept her chiefly because she couldn't get any other place on account of her coughing, so you could hear her all over the house. So now you know the names of all the household, and this is how they looked. Aunt Harriet was very small and thin and old. Grace was very small and thin and middle-aged. Aunt Frances, for Elizabeth Ann called her aunt, although she was really, of course, a first cousin once removed, was small and thin, and if the light wasn't too strong, might be called young. And Elizabeth Ann was very small and thin and little, and yet they all had plenty to eat. I wonder what was the matter with them. It was certainly not because they were not good, for no womankind in all the world had kinder hearts than they. You have heard how Aunt Harriet kept Grace, in spite of the fact that she was a very depressing person, on account of her asthma. And when Elizabeth Ann's father and mother both died when she was a baby, although there were many other cousins and uncles and aunts in the family, these two women fairly rushed upon the little baby orphan, taking her home and surrounding her henceforth with the most loving devotion. They had said to themselves that it was their manifest duty to save the dear little thing from the other relatives, who had no idea about how to bring up a sensitive, impressionable child, and they were sure, from the way Elizabeth Ann looked at 6 months, that she was going to be a sensitive, impressionable child. It is possible, also, that they were a little bored with their empty life in their rather forlorn little brick house in the medium-sized city, and they welcomed the occupation and new interests which a child would bring in. But they thought that they chiefly desired to save dear little Edward's child from the other kin, especially from the Putney cousins, who had written down from their Vermont farm that they would be glad to take the little girl into their family. But anything but the Putneys, said Aunt Harriet a great many times. They were related only by marriage to her, and she had her own opinion of them as a stiff-necked, cold-hearted, undemonstrative, and hard set of New Englanders.
I boarded near them one summer when you were a baby, Frances, and I shall never forget the way they were treating some children visiting there. Oh, no, I don't mean they abused them or beat them, but such lack of sympathy, such perfect indifference to the sacred sensitivities of child life, such a starving of the child heart. No, I shall never forget it. They had chores to do, as though they had been hired men.
Aunt Harriet never meant to say any of this when Elizabeth Ann could hear, but the little girl's ears were as sharp as little girl's ears always are, and long before she was 9, she knew all about the opinion Aunt Harriet had of the Putneys. She did not know, to be sure, what chores were, but she took it confidently from Aunt Harriet's voice that they were something very, very dreadful. There was certainly neither coldness nor hardness in the way Aunt Harriet and Aunt Frances treated Elizabeth Ann. They had really given themselves up to the new responsibility, especially Aunt Frances, who was very...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.